Okay, now we're going to solve and find the times and height of high and low waters at England on February 25, 2004. And our secondary fort is Fort of Folly Inn. Now to get that, we need to find where is February 25. So there you go, February 25. So the high water, the first high water in the morning is 0218, and at the afternoon is 1430. So how can we identify which one is the high water? So compare the times in the morning, which one is the higher. So compare 4.5 and 1.0. So the highest is 4.5 meters. So therefore, we're going to put on the box number 1, 2 or 0 to 18. And on beside is 4.5. As you can see there. Next is 1430 and 4.3. So 1430 and 4.3. On the lower, we have 742. That is 1 meter, and 1957. That is 1.1. Into the number 2 box, 742 and 1.0. 1957 and 1.1. Now to get the standard port seasonal change, the date is February, so you need to go to the part 2 of the secondary port. So to see what is the seasonal change for Portsmouth, this is number 65. If we're going to zoom in, that's number 65. So at seasonal change, this is 65, so it indicates negligible, so you can put 0. So there, 0. Next is the differences. Where do we get the information from the box number 7 and 8? So you need to find the value, where is 218? So in Portsmouth, 218 is at the middle of 00 and 12. So therefore, we're going to get minus 15 minutes. So there is minus 15 minutes. On the other hand, 1430 is at the middle of 600 hours and 1800 hours. So in Folly Inn, there is plus 15 minutes. So we need to put plus 15 minutes. In 742 is at the middle of 5 and 17. So 742 is at the middle of the 5 and 17. What is indicated here is 00. Okay? Now next one is 1957. 1957 is at the middle of 11 up to 23. So what is the value? It is minus 20 minutes. So minus 20 minutes. Okay, so in interpolation, to get the value of 4.5 is at the middle of 4.7 and 3.8. So you need to interpolate because there is no exact value. So to interpolate, 4.7 is at the middle of 4.5 is at the middle of 4.7 and 3.8. So to get the value of 4.7, it was in a poly negative 6. So negative 6 and then negative 4. No, negative 4. So the difference between 0.6 and x is x. 0.6 and 0.4 or negative 0.6 and negative 0.4 is negative 0.2. Difference between 4.7 and 4.5 is 0.2. Difference between 4.7 and 3.8 is 0.9. So to get that, x is over negative 0.2 and 0.2 is over 0.9. So to get the value of x, cross multiply to the x to be left alone, you need to cross multiply negative 0.2 to 0.2. So 0.2 multiplied by negative 0.2 divided by 0.9, it will give you negative 0.004. So this one will be the difference between 0.6 and the x. So by visual inspection, this one is increasing because this is negative. Why do you mean increasing? Because as long as it goes up to positive, it is increasing. As long as it goes up to negative, it is decreasing. So 0.6, we're going to minus 0.00044 to 0.6 to get the value of the x, and it will give you negative 0.55. So it will give you negative 0.55. There you go. Okay. Now to get the value of 4.3, another interpolation, 4.3 is at the middle of 4.7 and 3.8. Again, there's no exact value of 4.3, so we need to interpolate it. So it is in the middle of the 4.7 and 3.8. Same procedure. Get the value here. 4.7 to poly in for is equivalent to negative 0.6. Yeah. And 3.8 is equivalent to negative 0.4. There. See? Again, this is in poly in, huh? So we will get the value of 4.3 is equals to 0.51. Okay, the difference between negative 0.6 and x is x, negative 0.6 and 0.4 again is negative 0.2. 4.7 difference is 0.4 between 4.7 and 4.3. Difference between 4.7 and 3.8 is 0.9. To get the value, x is over negative 0.2 equals 0.4 over 0.9. To get the x, cross multiply 0.4 multiplied by negative 0.2 divided by 0.9. It will give you a negative 0.088. So you are going to apply it here. Again, by visual inspection, in order for us to know the value of x, what are going to do to the value that we get? So this one is increasing. So therefore, we need to, for example, 4. So next is 5, a negative 5. It's just a matter of trial and error in order to get the sequence. So 5, then negative 0.6. So 0.6 minus negative 0.6 minus negative 0.088, it will give you negative 0.51. Okay? So the value is negative 0.51. Excuse me. There you go. Now the value of 1.1, we need to interpolate again. 1.1 is at the middle of 1.9 and 0.8. So that is in the middle of 1.9 and 0.8, because there's no exact value again of 1. The value of 1.9, value of 1.9 at this standard port is negative 1. The value of 0.8 is positive 2. Where do we get that? Value of 0.8 is positive 2. We get that in polling, no? In the secondary port. So again, cross multiply to cut the story short. X is equals x is over 0.3. Parallelism 0.9 over 1.1. So to in order for the x to be left, you need to cross multiply 0.9 multiplied by 0.3 divided by 1.1. It will give you 0.245. Then you need to apply it again here by visual inspection. What will happen is should be increasing. So 0.1 should be added to 2.45. So therefore 1.0 is equivalent to 0.145. So 0.145 will be the barrier. Then to get the value of 1.1, again interpolation. Oops, sorry. So it is in the middle of 1.9 and 0.8. Okay, 1.9 is equal to 0.8. Equivalent of 1.9 is negative 0.1, and 0.8 is equivalent to positive 0.2. So we will get the value of 0.218. Then we need to apply it to negative 0.1. Okay.